Will the Bengals add a veteran linebacker? Hi again, everyone. I'm James Rapien with allbengals.com and Cincinnati Bengals Talk. And that is a question that I asked Zac Taylor on Wednesday afternoon. You're going to hear from the Bengals head coach in just a second. But first, let's talk about the injuries. Logan Wilson expected to miss at least the next two games, possibly more, and probably more. Sources tell Cincinnati Bengals Talk that it could be 4 to 6 weeks. And that means with five games to go, potentially a season-ending injury, that shoulder that Logan Wilson suffered, that injury he suffered on Sunday against the Chargers. And it's no surprise. Usually, if a shoulder injury is serious enough for a cart, you have an idea that it's pretty serious. So the Bengals haven't put him on injured reserve yet. I know ESPN's Jeremy Fowler had a report on Tuesday that sort of aligned with it, that, yeah, they're hoping, fingers crossed, that they can get him back at some point. But obviously, it could be much worse than a, you know, 1 to 2 game type loss with Wilson out. And when you couple that with Akeem Davis-Gaither likely out for the season, Jordan Evans definitely out for the season, and Joe Bachie expected to potentially start this week, depending on Marcus Bailey, it's Germaine Pratt, Joe Bachie, Marcus Bailey, and, well, maybe time for a veteran. And the thing that's really interesting is the Texans released Zach Cunningham on Wednesday morning for a couple of reasons. Look, he's a high-paid player on that roster. He signed a $58 million contract in 2020. But let's be honest here, and the Texans are a dumpster fire. He showed up late to a couple meetings, missed a COVID-19 test late last week, and so they released him. And I think that their loss could be the Bengals' gain. And some people are going to say, come on, the locker room issue, he's going to have locker room issues. I think a lot of guys are probably unhappy in that Houston Texans locker room right now. And so when I look at Zac Cunningham, I see a guy who had 164 tackles last year, 7 tackles for loss, 4 quarterback hits, and, you know, was all over the field, certainly a weapon that the Texans thought they could use and rely on in the future. He's a former second-round pick, 57th overall in the 2017 NFL draft. He's just 27 years old, turned 27 on December 2nd. Maybe that's why he didn't show up to his COVID test. He had came back from a birthday party or something. Who knows? But to me, given what we've seen from the Bengals this year, where they've aggressively addressed cornerback twice by claiming Trey Flowers and then Vernon Hargraves III, and Hargraves came from Houston. So you can walk on over to Hargraves and say, all right, what do you think about Zac Cunningham? You think he's going to fit here? What do you think about him? You know, and that's just, you know, a small piece of things. But he's subject to waivers, and I'm going to get to his contract in just a second. But here's what Zac Taylor had to say when I asked him if they planned on adding a linebacker.
Certainly looking to see what's out there. We've got a lot of guys that have been in here for months, weeks, that are ready to step up. But again, at this point in the year, when you have injuries, you're open to always looking to see what's out there. But there's nothing specific that I have to comment on. But I've got full faith that our guys are ready to step up. Our coaches have done Al's done a really good job with those guys, getting them ready. Darren always works those guys into special teams because he knows there's moments like this where guys are going to have to step up. So you don't want guys that are just alien to the scheme and haven't gotten any reps. So we feel fully confident our guys will be prepared and ready to step up.
Here's the beauty of claiming Cunningham. He doesn't have guaranteed dollars in 2022. It's an injury guarantee. So if he gets injured, but if you claimed him and you acquired him, it's $220,000. That's all you got to pay him for the rest of the year, because everything else was signing bonus. And he was basically making veteran minimum as his contract is concerned this year, because of all the money that was up front in the bonus earlier this year. And I believe it was a signing bonus. It might've been a different bonus, but my point is that was his base salary, around 900 grand. So you only pay under $300,000. You get him for the rest of the year. And who knows, maybe he plays really well, only 27 years old, and you think about maybe restructuring his deal or keeping him around in 2022, or you just move on and you get that money off the book. So I think Zac Cunningham certainly could be a target for the Cincinnati Bengals. What do you think? Should the Bengals claim him? Should they not? Are you worried about the locker room? Are you fine with Joe Bachie and company, Marcus Bailey, or would you want them to make a run at Zac Cunningham? We'll have the latest on Joe Burrow and all the injuries on Wednesday evening. Until then, for Andrew Fox Miller, I'm James Rapien, signing off for now, right here on Cincinnati Bengals Talk.